Hi friends, this is Akhil Reddy from Akhil Reddy Technologies, Hyderabad. I have nearly 10 plus years of experience in the area of software testing, in which I have 8 plus years of experience using automation tools like QTP and Selenium. First of all, today I will teach you how to work with Selenium WebDriver. Before going to Selenium WebDriver, we should learn what is Selenium, what are the components of Selenium. Okay, first, what do you mean by Selenium? Selenium is nothing but, it is a software which contains some set of programs. Selenium having four components. Selenium having four components. One is Selenium IDE. Second one, Selenium ORC. Third one, Selenium WebDriver. And Selenium Grid. Okay. Yeah. First of all, we will discuss about Selenium IDE. IDE is nothing but, it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs, we need to configure into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using IDE only. That means IDE is a user interface. No need to install somewhere. Okay. IDE is a user interface. Selenium IDE is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to install into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using IDE only. IDE is a user interface. IDE advantages. We have recording and playback facility and execution will be super fast. Two advantages. One is we have recording and playback facility and execution will be super fast. Next, disadvantages. It's work with only Firefox browser. And using Selenium IDE, we can perform very, very limited testing. That's why none of the people not using Selenium IDE nowadays. Selenium IDE getting deprecated. Next, Selenium RC. RC means remote control. Definition. Selenium RC is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to install into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse. Eclipse is nothing but it is a powerful editor to write the Java programs. In Selenium RC, we have one drawback. What is the drawback? Whenever you want to work with Selenium RC, we need to start the server manually and we need to stop the server manually. So, using Selenium RC also, we can perform very limited testing. That's why none of the people not using Selenium RC nowadays. Selenium RC also getting deprecated. After that, they made Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver is nothing but Same definition, Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver is nothing but, it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse only. Eclipse is nothing but, it is a powerful editor to write the Java programs. Using Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing. Both setup, Selenium RC setup, Selenium WebDriver setup is both same. But whenever you are comparing with Selenium RC, Selenium WebDriver having some powerful setup programs. That's why most of the people and most of the companies nowadays, they are encouraging only Selenium WebDriver only. Selenium is nothing but Selenium WebDriver only. Using this Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing. There is no limitations. And we can work with multi-browsers. And its Selenium WebDriver is very, very user-friendly. Without knowing anything, you can learn Selenium WebDriver very, very comfortably. And using, you know, even fourth class kid also, you can learn Selenium very easily. So, first, Selenium WebDriver. We will discuss, we will write to today first program. That is Selenium WebDriver. First program we will write today. So, before going to Selenium WebDriver, how to configure Selenium WebDriver? Okay, Selenium Web Driver is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. So in the place of user interface we are using. So first of all, we need to configure Selenium Web Driver programs into Eclipse. So how to configure Selenium Web Driver programs into Eclipse? How to configure Selenium Web Driver programs into Eclipse? Go to Eclipse. Just double click on it. Already I have Selenium WebDriver programs. Already I downloaded. So how to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse? Go to Project Explorer, take the new project, Java project, click on next. Give the name. Give the project name is Metro. Click on finish. After creating project, we can get SRC and JRE. So first, we need to configure the Selenium Web Driver programs in Eclipse. Just right click on project, go to properties, Java build path, libraries, add external jars, add the jars. Already I have libraries. Add external jars once again, come back, two more folders, open it and click on OK. Now this is Selenium WebDriver. So go to SRC and take the new class. That class name is WD1. Keep the mark public static void menu. Click on finish. Yes, this is Selenium WebDriver. This is the first class. How to work with Selenium WebDriver very comfortably. We will discuss now. Yeah. First of all, in Java we learn already. That is the syntax. That is interface name, reference name, equal to new class name. This is the Java concept. So here is interface is WebDriver. Reference name as your wish, WD. Equal to new class name, fine. In the place of class, I'm taking Firefox driver. I'm taking Firefox. If it is Internet Explorer, you can take Internet Explorer. If it is Chrome, we can take the Chrome driver. Now I am taking Firefox driver. Right. Whenever you are writing a web driver, WD should be cap. But and Firefox driver, F and D should be cap. Whenever you are importing the statements, that time automatically that will be changed. Your web driver. Firefox driver. Import. Change to Firefox driver. Right. If you want to work with any application, comfortably we can work. wd.get. If you want to work with any site, just we need to write like this. HTTP. I want to work with Gmail. gmail.com. Keep colon. This no need, this for general knowledge. This is the Java concept. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. That is the Java concept I wrote here. So no need of web driver WD equal new Firefox driver WD.get HTTP gmail.com. So save and click on run. It will open the Gmail page. So here is no need of Java, nothing. It's very easy to learn. You know, whenever you are comparing with QTP, it's very easy. So simply, we can work with any application, not only Gmail. If you want to work with any application, any web application, comfortably we can work. Yeah, we opened a Gmail page. Now I want to work with the Gmail page. So if you want to work with the Gmail page, first of all, we need to have Firebug and Firepath. Okay, what is Firebug and what is Firepath? I will teach you. Just wait 1 second. All right. First, each and every web element. For example, I have one web application. I have one web application. Each and every web button, each and every web button or web element, whatever it is, edit box or list box, combo box, connect box, whatever it is, each and every web element having one unique location. That unique location is nothing but XPath. That unique location is nothing but XPath. If you want to find out that this XPath, compulsory we need to have Firebug. We need to have Firepath. Firepath is nothing but it is a add-on of Firefox. It is an add-on of Firefox which is used for finding the XPath of the web element. XPath of the web element. Okay. Where we can get the Firepath? Firepath is we can get in Firebug. So first of all, we need to download Firebug also. Firebug is nothing but same. It is the add-on of Firefox, which is used for inspecting the web element. Firebug is nothing but it is the add-on of Firefox, which is used for inspecting the web element. So first of all, we need to download Firebug and Firepath. Then comfortably we can work with any application. So how to download Firebug? Now we will discuss. Now go to Mozilla Firefox. Go to Google. Now type here, download Firebug. Click on second link. Come down and click on an older version. Click on an older version. After that, we can get one window. Just click on 1.9. After that, 1.9.0, first one. After that, we can get one window. Just click on allow. It will take within seconds. We can get the Firebug. Just click on install now. Restart now. Browser will restart. Now type here. We need to have Firepath also. Just Firepath. Just click on first link. You can download the Firepath also. Just add to Firefox. Just click on install. Restart now. Okay. Already we have Firebug and Firepath. Now we can work with Gmail application. Okay. How to work with Gmail application? Observe carefully. Already we installed Firebug, Firepath. How to see? Just go to Tools, Web Developer, Firebug, Open Firebug. Okay, right. This is Firebug and Firepath. See, if you want activate or hide, we will use this option. If you want to hide the Firebug or activate the Firebug, we will use this option. This is the activator. If you want find out the XPath, we will use this option. And XPath, it will show you here. And this is the Firepath. Okay. Now, comfortably, we can work with any web element. So, observe carefully. Just go to Gmail. Gmail.com. Right. Already I told you, each and every web element having one unique location. That unique location is nothing but that is XPath. Now, just activate the this option. Click on it. Now we can get the XPath of the Gmail username XPath. Yes, this is the Gmail username XPath. Copy here. Copy and come to Eclipse. Now, if you want to enter gname wd dot, just click on F. Automatically option will come, find element, just write boy dot, I want to using XPath, I want to find out the web element XPath, give the XPath here, control V dot send keys, we are using send keys here, send keys, set the username Akhil Reddy HYD at gmail.com. Right, enough. I entered username. Now I want to enter password also. So password also same. WD dot find element. Oh, now application changed recently. Just we need to click on next button. So take the XPath of the next button. Yes, this is the XPath of the next button. Copy and we can paste also, but I'm writing manually. Observe carefully. Just after keeping a dot, just click on F, automatically option will come. Just by dot XPath, give the XPath, control V. This is the button. So we will use option click. If it is button, we will use click. You need to remember, okay, one is web radio button and link and button. Web radio button, link and button, we will use click option. Remaining all web element, any other just like if it is edit box, we will use send keys. So always we will use only send keys, only button, link, web radio button, we will use click operation. Next, WD dot, I want to give the password. After entering Akhil Reddy HYD, Akhil Reddy HYD. So I'm clicking on next button. So we can get password field. So we need to get the password XPath. So this is password XPath. Copy the password XPath, copy and come here and write here. Find element, WD dot. Find element by dot XPath, XPath control V dot password also send keys, that is the edit box. So password is 123456. This is the wrong password, but right. Now after that we need to click on sign in button. So activate the and click on sign in button. We can get the sign in XPath. Copy here and come to web driver WD dot find element by dot XPath. Give the XPath, control V and this is also button. So we will use click operation. Click. So here is no need of Java. So here observe carefully, here is any Java. So if you want to learn Selenium WebDriver, there is no need of Java. Just we need to remember only one thing. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. This is the syntax we need to remember. So if you have this syntax, WebDriver WD equal to new Firefox driver, comfortably you can learn Selenium WebDriver. Here is no need of any technology. Without knowing anything, you can learn Selenium WebDriver comfortably. This is the first class. I will teach you tomorrow second class. Hi, bye.